obviously John Wick is back into action again. The movie starts off as the ending of the first film and it continues onwards. Obviously, there is going to be different antagonists and we explore more about the world and the organization that John Wick was a part of before, including the Continental System and also not only the New York chapter, but also more of a Roman chapters and other perks that come along with being a member of this party, I shall say. The film's length is a lot longer than the previous one. It's almost 2 hours. That's because it showed off that organization that John Wick is a part of. And then there are a lot more characters to follow around, not only the antagonists, also their henchmen. The movie was very well choreographed. You don't see typical action stunts that are being performed, like helicopters jumping around in the buildings or so on. They're just strictly very physical action, I should say. They're just combating, a lot of gunshots, a lot of pistols, bigger guns, but yet the camera follows along quite well. There is a fight scene inside a very massive mirror room. You won't see the camera in any reflection of this. They might have removed it post production, or choreography was so well designed that very well made film in the action series. And I've read a lot of people who were saying that it is a reminiscent of old Western films, a lot of standoffs, music score was reminiscent of them, with including guitar. So it is a modern day take on a Western classic. Even though there's a lot of violence in this film, I should say I really enjoyed it because it was very well choreographed and very well shot. The camera didn't shake in this one. It was very smooth, very well followed, the scene that is happening. So I had a blast. It's almost as good as the first film, if not more. If you haven't watched John Wick yet, it's in theaters still. So go ahead and check it out.